In this video, we're going to start the CUDA Software Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet graphing quadratic functions. Before we get started on sketching the graph of each function, let's go over a quadratic function. A quadratic function is in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. Now I want to note a few things to help us graph. Looking at the a, if the a value is greater than 0, in other words, if that a value is positive, then when we sketch the graph of this function, the parabola will point up. So you can think of that as a cup. If the a is less than 0, if the a is negative, the parabola will point down like a frown. So if a is positive, the graph is going to open up, and if a is negative, the graph is going to open down. Now on each of these, whether it opens up or down, there will be a vertex. If the graph opens up, that vertex is known as a minimum. If it opens down, then it's known as a maximum. Because if you look at this first picture, that green dot is the lowest value, and then the rest of the values continue up. If you look at this other picture, the green dot is the greatest value, the maximum value, and all the other values will be going down, in the y direction, that is. Now, regardless of whether your parabola opens up or down, for a quadratic function, we're going to have an axis of symmetry. And that vertex that we talked about occurs on that axis of symmetry, meaning that the side to the right of that axis will be reflected to the side on the left, or vice versa. And that axis of symmetry, we can write as x equals the opposite or negative b over 2 times a. So essentially, when we're plotting this, the steps we're going to take, first we're going to see if it opens up or if it opens down. So we get a picture in our head of what we're dealing with. Then we're going to find that axis of symmetry. And once we find that axis of symmetry, we'll be able to plug x in and solve for y, so we get that vertex point, and then we'll plug a value or two in to the right of that, and since it's reflected, we know that those values will also be the same distance away from that axis of symmetry and with that same y value. So in each of these problems, we're only going to be calculating 3 points and then reflecting 2 more to draw our parabola or our curve. So let's get started in number 1. In number 1, we have y equals 3x squared. So our b value is 0 and our c value is 0. If we were to write this as ax squared plus bx plus c. Now our a value, we can see, is a positive 3. So we know that our graph is going to be opening up since that a value is positive. Remembering our axis of symmetry formula, let's find that axis of symmetry. X equals negative b over 2 times a. We know that a is 3, and b we can calculate because there is no plus x, so b is 0. Using our axis of symmetry formula, we'll have x equals negative b, so negative 0 over 2 times 3, which is 0 over 6, but 0 divided by any number is simply 0. So our axis of symmetry is on the y-axis. Knowing that, let's find our vertex. So we know our x-coordinate of our vertex is 0. So we're going to plug 0 in for x and solve for y. And I'll do that using a t-table. So x, y, we're plugging 0 in for x because that's our point where our vertex is, which in this case will be a minimum since it opens up. So 3 times 0 squared is 3 times 0, which is 0. So our vertex occurs at point 0, 0. Now let's look if x is 1. If x is 1, we'll have 3 times 1 squared, which is 3 times 1, which equals 3. Next, let's plot 1, 3. Now remember our axis of symmetry. So that point is reflected over that axis. So if we're 1 to the right of that axis, going 1 to the left, we will be able to plot another point. which is negative 1, 3. So we already have 3 points, but let's calculate another point, which will give us essentially 2 more points. So let's look at when x is 2. We'll have 3 times 2 squared, which is 3 times 4, which equals 12. So 2 comma 12. And then remember, our axis of symmetry, so since we're 2 to the right, if we go 2 to the left, that will be negative 2, 12. So now we have 4 points that we can connect to form our parabola. And note that this is a curve, so there should not be any straight lines. And number 2, we can see that our a value is equal to negative 1 half, so we know that our parabola is going to open down. So we're going to have a maximum vertex. And the b value and the c value are both 0. So calculating for our axis of symmetry, we'll have x equal to negative b over 2a. However, we know that if b is 0, even if a is a negative 1 half, our axis of symmetry is going to occur at x equals 0. So the x-coordinate for our vertex is 0 because it's going to fall on that y-axis. So looking at our t-table, for x, y values, if we plug in 0, for x, we'll get negative 1 half times 0 squared, which is 0. So our first point is 0, 0. Now let's plug in 1. If we plug in a positive 1, negative 1 half times 1 squared is equal to negative 1 half times 1, which is negative 1 half. So our next point is 1, negative 1 half. However, since it's a reflection and we're one step to the right, or essentially two grid lines, then going one step to the left of that axis of symmetry, or two grid lines to the left, at point negative 1, will also be at negative 1 half. Now let's plot 2 more points by looking when x is 2. Negative 1 half times 2 squared equals negative 1 half times 4, or essentially negative 4 over 2, which is negative 2. So when x is 2, y is negative 2, and also when x, since we're 2 to the right, going 2 to the left, when x is negative 2, we're also negative 2. So you can see that point is a reflection across our axis of symmetry. So now I'll connect those points with a curve. And that's our parabola, our quadratic function, graphed in number 2. In number 3, our a value is a negative 1, so we know that our graph is going to open down. Our b value is equal to 2, and c is 1. So in order to calculate the axis of symmetry, we know that x is equal to negative b over 2 times a. So negative 2 over 2 times negative 1 is going to be negative 2 over negative 2, which is positive 1. So our axis of symmetry occurs at x equals 1, so that vertical line where x is always 1. Now we know that the x-coordinate for our vertex is 1, but let's solve for the y-coordinate. Looking at our t-table, plugging 1 in for x, we'll get negative 1 squared plus 2 times 1 plus 1. Negative 1 squared is negative 1, plus 2 times 1 is 2, and then plus 1, negative 1, plus 2, plus 1 is going to be a positive 2. So when x is 1, y is 2. That is our maximum. Now let's look at when x is equal to 2. So we'll have negative 2 squared plus 2 times 2 plus 1. And that's plugging 2 in for x. Negative 2 squared is going to be negative 4 because we're squaring the 2 and taking the opposite of that. So 2 squared and then plus 2 times 2, which is plus 4, and then plus 1. Negative 4 plus 4 is 0, plus 1 is a positive 1. So now we can graph 2, 1, x is 2, y is 1, but remembering our axis of symmetry, that point is also going to be reflected with an x value of 2, or 1 unit to the right of that axis of symmetry, x equals 1. So if we go 1 x value to the left, we'll be at 0, and the y values are the same. So 0, 1. That was just reflecting 0.2, 1 over the axis of symmetry to 0, 1. Now let's pick one more point. Let's look at when x is 3. When x is 3, we'll have negative 3 squared plus 2 times 3 plus 1. So it'll be negative 9 plus 2 times 3 is 6 plus 1, which is going to equal negative 9 plus 6 is negative 3 plus 1 will be negative 2. So when x is 3, y is negative 2. And reflecting that point, since we're 2 units to the right, we'll go 2 units to the left of that axis of symmetry to be at negative 1, negative 2. Now I will connect those points to form my quadratic function. Let's move on to number 4. Number 4 will be the last problem that I'll do in this video. So before I go over the answer to this, remember to click that thumbs up button and also subscribe to my channel. Now, our a value is going to be a positive 2. So we know our parabola is going to be going up, opening up. Our b value, remember, ax squared plus bx plus c. And our b value we can see is going to be a negative 16. So for an axis of symmetry, we'll have x equals negative b, so the opposite of negative 16, all over 2 times a, which is 2. So the opposite of negative 16 is a positive 16, so I'll have 16 over 4 divided by 4, which equals 4. So our axis of symmetry is x equals 4. So finding when x is 4, we'll draw our axis of symmetry. So I know when x is 4, that will be my vertex, which happens to be a minimum since our graph opens up. So drawing my t-table, x, y, or I can write 2x squared minus 16x plus 33. When x equals 4, we'll have 2 times 4 squared minus 16 times 4 plus 33. So that's 2 times 16 minus 16 times 4, which is 64, plus 33. 2 times 16 equals 32. So we'll have 32 and we'll subtract 64 and then add 33. 32 minus 64 plus 33 is a positive 1. So our vertex occurs at 4 in the x and 1 in the y. So 4, 1 is our vertex. Let's look at our next point when x is equal to 5. So that's 2 times 5 squared minus 16 times 5 plus 33. So that's 2 times 25 minus 16 times 5, which is 80, plus 33. 2 times 25 is 50. And if we subtract 80 from that, we're at negative 33. And then if we add 33, we're at a positive 3. So graphing 5, 3. And then remember, the axis of symmetry, we can reflect that point. So reflecting that over that axis of symmetry will be at 3, 3. Now let's look at one more point when using that axis of symmetry. Reflecting it will give us 2 points. Let's look at when x is 6. So our reflected point, if x equals 6, is 2 away, or plus 2 from that axis of symmetry, if we take away 2, to positive 2. So when x is 6, we'll have 2 times 6 squared minus 16 times 6 plus 33. So that's 2 times 36 minus 16 times 6, which is 96, plus 33. 2 times 36 is 72, and when we take away 96 and then add 33, we'll get a positive 9. So at both 6 in the x and 2 in the x, we'll be at 9 in the y.